Yo, Adam Saxon with Kinda Cupid. In this video, I want to play around a little bit with line formatting. There was a post on Twitter, or X, whatever you're calling it, by Chris Majka, I hope I pronounced that right, where he said he's trying to do something to get a certain effect with lines, and what he's doing right now is overlaying the visual, and that's old school Power BI tweaking and tinkering. I love it. But Jeff Weir came back and suggested using error bars instead and fills on the line itself to get the same effect. All right, enough of all this talking. You know, we like to do it here in Guy in a Cube. Let's head over to my machine and see if we can replicate this. So this is effectively what they were trying to do. They have a line chart and they've got an area fill, and then they've got another line on top to kind of show a difference along with it. This is not an unusual request. And so what you'll see here is I've actually got two different line charts, and I've got one on top of the other with tinkering on the size just to try and get it to look right. Now, you need to know what the users of the report are going to do and possibly educate them a little bit if you're going to do this. I've seen this approach a lot of times too with overlaying and doing certain effects to get a specific look that you want for the visual. And it's cool. You can do a lot of cool things and make it look amazing by doing that. But you're sacrificing things as a result of that. One is the interactivity of the visuals. Let's see if we can do this without overlaying visuals. So what I'm going to do is just take the first visual, and I'm going to go to option two, and let's go and paste it. You can see here I'm actually using an area chart here. I'm going to change it to a line chart, and then let's go to shade area. So we're going to shade it like it was. And then what I want to do is what Jeff suggested is use error bars. So let's use error bars. So we're doing total sales amount. Let's grab our total shipping amount that we were using before, and we'll say upper bound. We'll enable that. And right now you'll see like there's these bars and stuff that are on there. I don't want that. So we got to tweak this a little bit. So I'm going to turn off bars and we'll turn on error bands. And we got to do a little bit more tinkering here. So we'll say, let's do a line, and then we'll change the color. Let's just change it to black, and we'll change the transparency all the way up. So now we've got that. This is good, and this kind of gets me what I want. However, there's a difference here. Christopher came back and said, yes, that was brilliant. However, I've tinkered around with this, and on the error bar, let me know in the comments if I'm missing something, because I can't get that error bar to be dashed. It is only a solid line. I think I know what Christopher did, and I'll show that to you in the next step, but I don't think he used the error bars to do this. But using the error bars is a cool trick, right? Again, interactivity, I haven't played with that extensively, so you got to validate, is that really going to look the way you want it to look. So let's go back to option three. Let's change this to a line chart. We're going to do the same thing again. We'll say shade area. Cool. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring in my total shipped amount and just add it to the Y axis. And you'll be like, ooh, wait, that changed some things. Let's go back to shade area, and I'm going to say shipped sales. I don't want to show the shade for that area. That's good. Now what I want to do is for the line, let's go back to the shipped sales amount, and I'm going to say that I want that to be dashed. And for the color of this line, I want to change that. Now you can see this is kind of the result of what Christopher had posted. And I think this is what he did, where we just added a second line. And now in these different options, you can tweak the different formatting for the different lines so that you can get this effect. Pretty bananas, right? What I would leave you with is there are a lot of different options inside of Power BI. Tinker around. Tinkering is where you find all the amazingness inside of visuals inside of Power BI. And you get to learn things about what works and what doesn't. It's endless. Whew. This isn't specific to the line chart, right? Do this with other visuals. Go to town with the pie chart, if you will. Oh, and I can feel the comments already dropping in. Don't use a pie chart. It's fine. All right, let me know if you've got another way. If you know how to get that error bar to be dashed, let me know in the comments, because I couldn't figure that out. Or if you just have other thoughts about how to approach this, I would love it. Share it. Continue the conversation, if you will. As always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.